just appreciate for getting the invitation to share a few comments on behalf of Fondo per Pietà and Franklin Templeton. And I'll just quickly run through a few slides because you're running kind of late, and I guess there will be a lot of questions after all the speeches. So first of all, I just want to quickly remind everyone where we are in terms of corporate governance and the structure of Fondo. This is the evolution of the shareholder structure from the time when we took over, so 4.5 years. We've been able to really attract a lot of new foreign institutional investors that were not present before. We estimate that they spend on Fondo shares more than 1.3 billion euros. But what I also want to remind everyone that when we started, there were voting restrictions for all the private shareholders except for the government. So effectively, with 39% government was fully controlling the shareholder votes at the shareholders meeting. One of the first decisions when the government reduced its stake was for us to recommend to remove all these limitations to make sure that one share means one vote, and there are also no restrictions for holding the shares. And that's one of the key principles of any corporate governance, and that's what investors look at when investing in companies. They want to make sure that if they put money in, they're able to execute the voting rights, and they have full rights to all the shares. The second part of the corporate governance, of course, is the board that is fully non-executive. In case of Fondo, we very likely to have that kind of profile of people, both with Romanian and international experience, legal background, financial background, specialist in closing funds. And I think it's very, very key to make sure that the board members are also fully independent from the managers. Otherwise, there can be a lot of conflicts that shouldn't be occurring, especially in case of closing funds. And then the structure of our operations here. One key point that I want to raise here is the alignment of the interests of the shareholders and the fund managers. That sounds like obvious, but in many cases there are a lot of issues also in developed worlds around what the manager's strategy or what shareholders want to achieve. And what shareholders want to achieve, from my perspective, it's very easy. You want to make money, you want to return. So the manager should do everything to deliver this. And it's ideal a situation where this is also addressed in the fees that the manager is getting. And in this fee structure that we have, where the base fee is based on the market cap, and that the distribution fee is still pretty unique for London-based or US-based funds, but that's where the industry is going. So we can say that Fondo London from Romania is a bit ahead of the crowd in terms of setting this fee structures. Now, in terms of the regulations, we are heavily regulated, like any financial institution. Not only us, I hear the same from the banking sector as well, and not only from Romania, but also in other countries. Because right now we have three laws that we fall under. One is the special Fondo law, another one is the capital markets law, and another one is the companies law. And now we're getting the fourth one, which is the AIFMD and the legislation that would be forward that we have to comply with. We just have to live with it. One thing from the regulator and the lawmakers should take care that there are no contradictions in this law, because very often, these are all the approvals that we require as fondo proprietata from the regulator, that's constituent IVA, the investment management agreement, and the shared increases, change of headquarters, and so on. On top of this, there are also additional regulations that approvals from the regulators that are needed for the branch, what investors are interested in. wasn't